son of a black woman. What did the Prophet Muhammad say that now came or say to him? Ya Abadar, fika jahiliya. Or Abu Dhar, you still got jahiliya inside you. How can you say this about Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu? If you read the seerah of Bilal, if you read his sifat, his characteristic, there's nothing, with all respect to Bilal, there's nothing beautiful about Bilal. But yet what makes him the most beloved to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whereby the Prophet Muhammad says about him, Ya Bilal, I heard your footsteps in paradise. What is it that made me hear your footsteps in paradise? He said, there's nothing special about me. You know, even every time I make wudu, I read 2 units of prayer. Those are the footsteps of Bilal in paradise. Bilal on Imam ala anhu, he stopped giving the adhan upon the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, how can I give the adhan when I come to ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah wa Rasulullah laysa ma'ana, when the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is no longer in front of me? I can't utter these words no more. Historians, muarrikhun, they write, only in 2 or 3 occasions did ever Bilal ever say the adhan after the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On one occasion, you find, when they conquered Philistine, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liberate him once again. Umar ibn Khattab said to Bilal, call the adhan once again. Call the adhan so we may recall the adhan of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Bilal began to make the adhan, and when he reached to ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, all of the companions began to weep. Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar al-Khattab began to weep. He is calling the name Muhammadur Rasulullah. No longer is the Prophet Muhammad in front of us. The adhan reminded them of those beautiful days. Those are the days that we want to remind our companions about. Yes, we may live at what these people call the dark ages. That's what thrives our iman. That's what burns our iman. That's what makes us relive our iman. If you think about those glorious days, think about those companions. Those companions who had hardly any clothing, had hardly any food. But that simple individual conquered the east and the west. And we're running from the north to the south. We cannot even conquer one simple location.